Okay, we're on. Hello, everyone. This is Sylvain from Gatineau, Quebec, just next door to the National Capital Region of Canada. Before I begin reading my paragraph of truth, I would appreciate it if those of you who care to know about the truth behind the global crisis subscribe to my YouTube channel now so you can be notified of the next videos I'll be sharing and videos on my 12 steps the truth that many of you are taking with me already now. These steps can be taken anywhere in the world, and they are simple, and they're safe, sound, and surefire, I believe. Remember that we only discover truth when we actually start seeking it, and those of you who have sought the truth know exactly what I'm talking about. This is something concrete. But anyways, those of you who trust your government's management of the crisis and are willing to stay in your homes for up to a year, watching everything that you love about this good old world crumble around you, then don't perk your ear to listen to what I'm about to say. And here is my message. I call it the paragraph of truth. All of a sudden, people of all nations have been sectioned off into containment areas, and most of us may remain under home arrest for 1 year or more, if we're not considered essential workers. Now, over time, those who survive this ordeal will gradually lose all their possessions and all their security, while prisoners will likely be freed, possibly to make room for those of us who don't comply with the new global directives. If need be, some homes may become prisons and your presence there tracked. Most of us will be tested, tracked, or traced, as they call it, isolated, then vaccinated by the force of the new global directives. We have lost our freedom of mobility, as you know. Freedom of assembly, freedom to work, freedom to travel, freedom to visit nature, to go to the park, to walk in empty fields, freedom to date, freedom to babysit our grandchildren, freedom to visit our parents or partners in another city, freedom to visit our sick, freedom to hold funerals, and soon we will lose our freedom of expression and the freedom to refuse vaccination. We will lose that as well. The state is in charge of humanity now and soon will be given an electronic ID, a global ID, to permit us to live in a strange new world where people may serve foreign masters or machines, since small businesses will be gone. Many of them are gone already. Restaurants primarily, but others as well. And this is the new normal that all our leaders, including religious leaders and union leaders, are asking us to get used to. Doesn't make sense. Our freedoms will never return if we just sit and wait for a year. We all know that. The virus did not cause the crisis. Some people did, and they're making a killing on it. I'm not saying that the virus is not real. I'm saying that the reaction to this over-exaggerated reaction to it, is causing a problem worse than the virus itself. Okay, there will be more people bankrupt or suicided, if that's a word, than the virus can kill. So those who mounted this crisis are using it for their own ends and refuse to answer our questions. But our questions are ready for future leaders, those who will replace them. Instead, this new global voice steers us by repeatedly saying testing, tracking or tracing, isolation, vaccination. They repeat this day after day in every state, in every nation, in every media. Repetition is hypnotizing the masses into accepting slavery, poverty, and possibly even perpetual confinement. But not me. We can defeat this easily, peacefully, within a week, using words only, intelligent and caring human words. So that's my paragraph of truth. It's a shocking and gloomy portrait of our current situation, I know, but is it accurate? That's the important thing. Positive thinking will not save us from this situation. Positive doing will, and that's what we're doing. All the positive thinking in the world can't even turn on a light switch in your room. I've begun the 12 steps with my friends. The steps are legal, ethical, simple, fast. They take seconds a day, at the most maybe 5 minutes a day, and they are democratic. But most of all, they're fun. And some are even as addictive as video games like Doom. So in conclusion, my friends and I hate no one. We have no prejudices. We just want our freedom. We want to know the truth. We want our questions answered. We want to get back to work while maintaining social distancing, of course. And most of all, we refuse to remain under home arrest for the next 4 to 12 months. A few words about for specific groups. A word to 5G installation crews. If you know for a fact that the towers you install are harmful to life, please take a few days off and think about what it is you're doing to all of us, including yourself. A word to police officers. As you know, police officers anywhere in the world, as you know, many of our freedoms have been taken away from us, and even from you, and even from yours. Please don't oppress people with fines for safe behaviors or for speaking different opinions. No one, not even you, want to live in a police state. A word to the members of the Canadian Armed Forces. I have no advice for you, just words of thanks and gratitude. You have always been above reproach when you worked with Canadian citizens. I know. I remember you, during the OCA crisis, 1990, after the SQ couldn't handle the situation. You were real heroes with the non-natives, like myself, and you managed to use words, not bullets, to end a conflict with the natives. You made no enemies. You resolved a crisis without shooting a bullet. I still have a picture of your green armored personnel carriers in my driveway in front of my home back then. And I also remember you during the 1970 War Measures Act that Pierre Trudeau started. You took the time to smile at me often when I was just a teenager. I remember that. I remember the curfews. I remember you being so diplomatic. You were real peace officers. And of course, during the last flood in Gatineau, the sandbagging and all the help you provided with us with. We know that you're on our side, and we're on your side as well too. So I have no word except gratitude and thanks for the members of the Canadian Armed Forces. A word to journalists. We all know that you're not free to report on what you want and how you want to report it. The alternative media could be a good option for you to consider as artificial intelligence writers take over some of your jobs gradually. We hear they do a pretty good job of handling the 5 W's. Finally, a word for everyone else. If you want to wait a few months for the new world to settle in, you might be disappointed. Email me instead. I think you have the time to do that. Thank you.